Hi guys, this is Vicky. In this video, I want to share with you how I practice my basic chipping skill effectively. I am currently studying PGM program at U of Idaho, and I also play on the women's golf team. Because I'm not a professional golf coach yet, so in today's video, I will only share my practice process and some tips with you. If you're interested in this video, keep watching. Before you hit any balls, basic warm-up is super important for you. This will not only relax your body, but also prevent injury. Then I will use an alignment stick and just put it in the place that without too much slope. The distance is up to you, but usually I will set it around 10 yards. Next, you need 6 tees and insert them around the stick. I usually put 4 feet at different angle just to make it look like a circle. I know it's kind of hard to see my tee on this screen, but yeah, just trying to make a round. After we set up everything, we can finally start practice. I will say that this next step is pretty much the essence of the entire practice, and it is also something that few people do. Yes, chipping do need warm up. I will spend like 5 minutes on every club that I want to practice today, and usually it's my 52 and 58 degree. The purpose of this step is mainly to fully relax your body and focus on hit it solid. In this 5 minutes, I want you to feel your club face and maybe focus on your tempo. After complete the first step, you can get into the second step. I will put 10 balls each on 10, 15, 20, 25 yards from the target. This time, you cannot just care about whether you are playing solid or not. You have to find a way to hit the ball into the circle. This training is mainly to strengthen your stability and force you to think a little bit before you hit every shot, because you need to adjust your direction and swing or even the height of the shot. Like how we did back then.
got me on your head. He ain't never gon' hold ya. He ain't never gon' console ya. He probably never knew that we grew through our memories. Didn't you notice? He never really wanted. Just
you know how I feel. You know how to reach. You know what the deal is. You know that it's real. You know it was.
The final step. Record. So I will put another 5 ball on the same place that you just practiced, but this time you have to treat these 5 balls as a tournament. Also, after you hit it, you have to write down your score as a record so that you can track whether you improved or not, or even like which specific yardage that you might need to practice more. This practice is for you to maintain your standard even under the pressure. So for example, I'm chipping from 15 yards uphill right now. There are 3 inside the circle and 2 are not. So I will put 3 out of 5 on my record sheet. The record sheet that I designed this time is divided into uphill, downhill, left to right hill, and right to left hill, and the range is from 10 to 25 yards. Therefore, if you finish the test on this 4 direction and 4 distance, you can record your total score. Then next time when you practice, you can see if you continue to improve. And just for the remind, you need to complete the 10 ball practice before taking the 5 ball test. The entire practice actually takes about an hour and a half, but trust me, if you follow the step, times will actually pass quickly than you think it was. And the time you spend on it are a fiction, because you are keep thinking and adjusting. By the way, I really like the chipping record sheet that I designed this time. So if you also like it and want to use it to record your practice, you can download it from the description box. I will put the link at there. So yep, this is how I practice my short game. I wish this video can help you to improve your golf game. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time!